Here is another passage now from Burke that is invents this very famous little idea of what's called the little platoon. Turbulent, discontented men of quality, in proportion as they are puffed up with personal pride and arrogance, generally despise their own order. One of the first symptoms they discover of a selfish and mischievous ambition is a profligate disregard of a dignity which they partake with others. Now, this is, he's basically saying that, like, class traitors, that is, the wealthy and powerful who condemn wealth and power, are showing in themselves a certain ingratitude and peevishness. And this is something that we see now, right? Famously, one of the co-founders of BLM was just revealed to be buying all these expensive properties in California. But there's a million examples of this, right? It's the aristocracy who goes in for Marxism. And then they sort of do this thing called consciousness raising, where they have to convince people that they're oppressed. You have to convince gay people in this country that they're, you know, that every word is a microaggression. You have to convince people that, like, the police are out trying to shoot black people. These lies that they tell people. I mean, I don't know if you guys saw this video of this poor woman pulled over in just an absolute state of horror because she had been told by the media, by the New York Times, right? By all of these, by these powerful moneyed interests who have an interest in her being radicalized, in feeling as if she's under assault by every American cop, right? This is how these revolutions actually work. They're inner revolutions within the upper classes of these people that are disgusted with their own wealth on the lines of some of the stuff we talked about last week, right? This idea that Christianity condemns wealth or at least tells us that wealth is a barrier to holiness. And therefore, once we kind of move away from Christianity, we just have that self-condemnation, right? So he's saying, what's the alternative? He says, to be attached, this is Burke again, to be attached to the subdivision, to love the little platoon we belong to in society is the first principle, the germ, as it were, of public affections. It is the first link in the series by which we proceed towards a love to our country and to mankind. The interests of that portion of social arrangement is a trust in the hands of all those who compose it, as none but bad men would justify it in abuse, none but traitors would barter it away for their own personal advantage. We are now being told how evil it is to love our native land, to love your country, right? Patriotism is next to jingoism, and all the horrors of the 20th century were all about nationalism, right? But this is deeply, deeply unnatural, and we think that by throwing off the shackles of borders, right, by getting rid of the nation state, well, then we'll just create this grand, you know, brotherhood of man all across the world, and, you know, a brotherhood of person, right, all across the world in love. But of course, as Burke recalls, as the Stoic idea of oikeosis reminds us, right, these things don't actually happen in abstract from the top down. They are built from the ground upward. Your love of even of yourself, of your home, of your family, right? These are the schools in which you learn to love other men, in which, you know, love thy neighbor as thyself doesn't make any sense unless you first love what is nearest and dearest to you, and then you expand that love outward throughout the world. Hey, you thought this video was over. It is not. We have something very important to talk about, and that is freedom of speech. Freedom of speech has become a disaster on the major tech platforms. Platforms like Twitter and Facebook are just cracking down on stuff, especially on folks like us who don't maybe think in line with every dictum of the woke orthodoxy. I created the Young Heretics community on Locals as a way of delving deeper into the stuff we love to talk about on this show, the great works of the West, the traditions, the masterworks, the principles, right? It's a great way for us to connect and get to know one another better. If you go to youngheretics.com/locals, you can check out this community. And if you become a VIP, you get all sorts of extra stuff. You get episodes a week in advance. You get articles I write that you can only find as a VIP. And it's also a really cool way to connect at a more personal level. So I do stuff like I post my workouts, right? I post, you know, what I'm reading. We talk about our book collections, but also, like, you know, beard care tips and whiskey recommendations, all this stuff. Right now, you can get an annual membership to become a VIP. And that is really the best way to sign up. It's $56 a year. And if you subscribe monthly, it's $7 a month. So the annual membership is 4 months free. You go to youngheretics.com/locals, sign up for the whole year. It's $56, and we can stick it to big tech together while getting to know one another and the West more deeply. Youngheretics.com/locals. I will see you on the other side.